Our founders, as they wrote the Declaration of Independence, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, and among these are life, the right to life. And if you have the right to life, then maybe you can have liberty, and then maybe you can have the pursuit of happiness. By the way, the pursuit of happiness in the original documents in the Virginia Declaration pertained to the right to own property. I wish we had time to go back and make the biblical case of how Scripture sees the ownership of private property rights. We're losing those liberties rapidly today. The word abortion is not found in the Bible, but the concept for pro-life is strongly there. Jeremiah chapter 1, look at your outline, you see it printed there. Jeremiah 1, God speaks of when Jeremiah was still in the womb. Psalm 139 is a gripping text that talks about God forming us while we were yet in the womb. Those first the verses 13 through 16 are spellbinding. And then Luke chapter 1, as Elizabeth and Mary meet each other, John the Baptist in utero jumps, he leaps for joy coming into the presence of Jesus, who is embryonic at that point, a preborn baby. It is estimated annually there are 1.4 million abortions a year. I don't even like to use the word abortions anymore. When I'm doing media interviews, I switch and talk about this phrase, ripping up babies in the womb. Tearing up babies in the womb is not a good thing. An abortion is happening in America every 20 seconds. Someday, the abortuaries of this nation will be closed. And when that happens, history will be hard on them. Just like we tour the concentration camps of Germany. Someday, there will be tours of the abortuaries. And people will say, where on earth was the church during that time of the Holocaust? One-fifth of all pregnancies end in abortions. And among African Americans, it's catastrophic. They only make up 13% of the population, but 40% of the abortions. It's atrocious what's happening there. The largest Planned Parenthood in America is the six-story complex recently dedicated in Houston. I've seen it numbers of times. Located intentionally right next to the black area and the Hispanic areas. The Holocaust is enormous. Walter Hoy, one of my close friends, African-American out of Oakland, California, is leading a charge to wake up African-Americans to help them realize they are literally an endangered race because of the Holocaust of abortion. Now, what candidates go with the Bible on this? What candidates are in contrast to the Bible? Those that are pro-life, as the Bible is, Herman Cain. Newt Gingrich stands for life. Michelle Bachmann stands for life. Ron Paul has delivered many babies as a doctor. He stands for life. It makes it a little bit more challenging, though, because he tends to be so libertarian, he does not support any kind of enforcement on federal levels. He tends to be only state-driven. Makes it more complex, but he's radically pro-life. I've heard him actually speak on this and give some incredible scriptures on it. Rick Perry is strongly pro-life. Mitt Romney has flip-flopped. He was pro-abortion when he was governor of Massachusetts. He says he is pro-life now, a little harder to know for sure. Rick Santorum, strongly pro-life, 7 children. In fact, when I call him and talk with him, I always close by saying, let me pray over Bella, their last child, their youngest child, a baby. That baby would have been aborted because of all kinds of complications had it not been there a strong pro-life family. She requires 24/7 care. It is absolutely staggering what's required for that little child. And Rick acts like he's so proud and so excited of that special daughter, Bella. And so when I always finish the conversation, I said, I want to pray over her. He said, wait a minute. I want to move right beside her and hold the phone so she can hear you praying for her. Those that are for abortion are Barack Obama, the most pro-abortion president in the history of America. We've never seen anything like this. And then a Republican named Gary Johnson, who's running for president, is pro-abortion. And then John Huntsman's position is frankly unclear. It's a bit of ambiguity. I would never vote for a person who has ambiguity on this issue. I shift from abortion to fiscal and economic issues right now. Now, the temptation is for people to say, okay,